Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. After a while, I'm coming to share with you one of journals I've been working on this for a very long time, And Angie, who belongs to this journal, it's waiting for this journal really. Oh my God, she's very patient. She's very patient, I have to say. That she's amazingly kind to me. And I really hope she will like that. I've got many projects to share, but I had horrible time. And it's getting so long time to sort it out. And it drive me to that mood when I wasn't able to take video because I was swearing so much. You know, when something bothers you and you try to sort it out and it's no way and you can't find the help anywhere. And it's about my work, about my proper work, which I have. And I love that work. I love that job, but management changed nearly a year ago. And since that, it's, oh my God, I learned loads of bad words in English. So I wasn't able to take video because it will be horrible. I will put you in the same mood which I was before. Now I'm starting to get over it and just wait if someone will help me or not. So finally, I finished this journal, finally. And I have got loads of projects to share with you guys. And I am so thankful that you are so patient with me. You are so kind and you cheer me up all the time. So this is journal for Angie. She wanted something in kind of grungy styles. Something where maybe will be something spiritual. Or grungy. Or in that steampunk style. And I hope I mix that somehow all together. Hopefully I mix that. I have a fun with this one because it's long time when I didn't make something grungy. So this is... this is cover of my journal. It's pretty simple. I used, again, leather. Here I used those beads. Loads of laces on that top and those metal embellishment. And I left it blank. Not blank. I left it just simple without any embellishment because I thought, I think my camera is going down. I'm not sure why. Oops. Sorry for that. Hopefully it will hold it now. No, oh, it's not holding now. It's going down again. I'm sorry. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I can't fix it. Whoops la. Hopefully you will see everything. You will see also my mess over there. Hopefully it will hold down. I'm sorry for that. It's everything. It's some kind of crazy. Oh, God. Not sure when I finished. So this is cover of the journal. And I left it without any embellishment because Angie is going on her surgery very soon. And I was thinking if she will be in her bed and I will have here some embellishment. It will, you know, it will, when you will want to move it, it will catch up that bedding, that cover of duet. I think it's bedding. So I left it simple, but inside it's embellished a lot. And I really hope you will like it, guys. I used, again, those gorgeous papers, which I've got from Victoria Design. Hopefully I'm saying that right. From Victoria Design, those papers. I used loads of beautiful calligraphy papers I found on, oh my God, dreamers.com. No, Dreamers. I will have to have a look. It's a page where you pay for monthly subscriber, and you can download as many images as you want, hopefully, because I'm loading a lot now. And I used those gorgeous images. All those are from Victoria Design. If I will find links for those collections, I will put it to down below. And this other stuff, it's from Pinterest. And also from the Graphic Fairy webpage, there is thousand amazing images for free, Graphic Fairy, I believe. I will put links for those websites down below. So this is my first page. Here I made pocket for two tags. And here is small pocket, and I forgot to put there some small tag. I will have to put there some small tag. And I embellished that with this filigree and this small circle. And this number, and when you turn it here, it's another pocket. And here is small gate card or gate tag. So some extra space for journaling. And I use this gorgeous lace I've got in my stuff for embellish this page. Here is another gorgeous grungy image. And I use this tea bag like my pocket. And here you can see this is one of few pages I've got from that Victoria Design. I hope I will find this collection, but if not, I will put a link for Victoria Design Etsy shop down below so you can see all that gorgeous stuff they've got over there. Here I used that embossing folder, and I embossed card, and I make it like my pocket here from the top. Oops, come on, it's pocket there, okay, it's pocket here. And I've got here those cards. Here is space for journaling. And also I decorated here with small die. I've got it's Marianne Design die. Here is few pages for journaling. This is from Victoria Design. Those vintage papers. This paper, it's... that ledger paper, and I found it on Pinterest, this one. And when you open it, oh my god, it's still going down my camera. I will have to fix it somehow. When you open it, you've got another pages for journaling. Here is like small tag spot and this beautiful card. And here is another tag spot. You will once saw, here is tag spot. Here is an image from Pinterest. I found it when I wrote down vintage calligraphy. So it was showing me 100 images, beautiful images. And here is tag spot. And I used this this notepaper. And I made it like tag. So it's here. Another page for journaling. And here you can see that gorgeous paper from Victoria Design. And here I use that CD cover like my pocket, and inside it's this gorgeous lady photography, and behind that from this side it's small pocket for this tag. So it's here. I'm gonna close it down. When we turn it over, here is another that beautiful paper. Here I've got tag spot and another gorgeous paper. I think this collection, it's called vintage papers or something like this. I will try to find it. Here another great image from Pinterest. I found it when I tried to find tarot cards. I believe it's called tarot cards. Here I've got those coffee dyed papers, and I used my wallpaper, that dimensional wallpaper, and I made this beautiful coffee dyed paper. Here you can see those flowers from my wallpaper. Here that ledger paper. And here is like belly band, and I decorated with laces and with my homemade flowers. I'm still very proud of those flowers. And here just few tags. And I still have got loads of ephemeras alongside that need to be cut out. So I think I will include a few of them here as well. This is from Czech Republic. It's like postcard. And here you can see that coffee dyed effect. And I made like tag spot here. And here is another tag spot. And I use this beautiful image from Pinterest. Here is like space for journaling. And I used Tim Holtz. Oh my god, I forgot that stencil. Oh, I forgot that name. And it's like folder here, not folder. It's like closed few papers for journaling. Oh, here I forgot to those pockets to put something. Here is pocket. Here is few pages for journaling, coffee dyed, all of them. Hopefully I am in view. All of them are coffee dyed. Here is another pocket. I will have to put some ephemeras inside. And it can be closed, so it can be like separate writing space for some special information. And it closing with those clock hands. And here I've got another paper, inspiration from Victoria Design. And I used like embellishment, this beautiful, beautiful brochet. I really like that because it's so shiny and it's grungy at the same time. And I used those eyelets to holding all that strip or trim. And here is pocket. Hopefully you can see all because my camera is going down. I'm not sure what is happening over there. And here a few tags, I made that, those tags. Other side, it's just linen paper. Oh, here I've got small doily. And this is just extra space for journaling. Here I've got like tag spot. And again, this gorgeous paper from Victoria Design. I really hope you can see everything. Not sure what, why my camera is going down. And here we've got writing papers. Oh my, I didn't take coffee dyed papers. I didn't take video for a long time, so now I am very nervous. And this is paper I found when I typed, I think astrology or astronomy. One of those words to Pinterest. And vintage astronomy or, I think vintage astronomy or astrology. And it found me those circles. I'm not sure what for they use that, but it looks gorgeous. So I use it here. Again, coffee dyed papers. And again, another image from those cards. Oh, did you see that? Hopefully, yes. Here is another page with tag spot. This gorgeous ephemera. This is from the Graphic Fairy webpage, this one, Graphic Fairy. Here I made ops. Yes, for last few weeks I'm watching so many videos with that craft fair. I thought I'm going on a craft fair this year, I'm gonna try it. But unfortunately I'm very busy at my work at that time when craft fair is here. So I'm not going on craft fair, but I made so many things you can sell on craft fair. I'm not sure where I will sell it now because it's so many. And I'm going to share with you in some of next videos. And I learned those book pages. I watched a video from Tmika. She scrapped that word. I will put her link down below because she's got loads of gorgeous, gorgeous, interesting videos about craft fair products. And also Scrapping Mommy, I think I'm saying that right, that lady, it's so funny, she's amazing crafter, and she made so many beautiful and interesting videos as well. So I will put links down below, and I made this bookmark, and also one there, in different styles, so I'm placing here for Angie. And here I used again that CD cover, like my pockets. Inside it's this gorgeous lady who is a dream teller, I think, or not just dream teller, fortune teller. And here I made grungy paper clip. Hopefully you can see that I use those images. Those are from Victoria Design as well. And here is pocket. This is from Victoria Design as well. This tag. When you turn it, you've got page here, and I made those small tags. This is Tim Holtz stamp, and here is another Tim Holtz stamp. So I made those small tags here. I put Angie surname start with S, so I found this heart with S, so I included here like embellishment. And this I found on Pinterest, I believe, when I wrote down black black and white calligraphy background, I believe. Black and white calligraphy background on Pinterest. And here I used this paper, and from one side is paper, from another side it's just black ribbon. And I made it like holder from this teeny mini space, journaling space. So it's few pages here, and you can close it with those rusty rings, half rings, not sure how to collect those. Hey, come on, come here. Oops, no, okay, no. I will close it later. Oh, oh God. And here another beautiful image when I wrote down, I think, fortune teller or that astronomy again. No, this is that paperclip, so you can close it like here, this. And here we've got another bookmark. It's that would you slide around your journals. So I use those gorgeous buttons and this hair band. And it's on that polka dot ribbon. And here I've got again a CD cover. I embossed it this time and colored it with Gather Things, I think. It was that ink I used. And here I've got another grungy image from, this is from Graphic Fairy web page. And here again from Victoria Design, this beautiful tag. It's from The Magic Apothecary. I can't say that again, but it's from that collection. And it can be open again. Here I made small pocket with this tag. It looks like this. Oops. And here I embellished that with this small moon. And I embossed again that pocket. It's coin envelope, and I embossed it, and I use it here like my pocket. And from this side, it's two teeny mini pockets for small tags. It's this one and this. So it's two teeny mini pockets here. And I used few laces like my embellishment. And when you open it, it's again few pages for journaling. And here I've got extra space for journaling. Here another paperclip, altered paperclip. And this card, those pages for journaling, coffee dot pages. And here again, CD pocket. And I decorated with laces and with this metal filigree. And I used this image. This is from Pinterest. Oh, it can be. It can be anyway. You choose. And this is extra space for journaling. And you can close it like this. And here we've got another two pockets from those tags. And I use those beautiful stamps. They are, if I am not wrong, they are from Seven Gypsies collection. But it's old collection of stamps. Dream and Wish. They are in those two pockets. And here I decorated just with this die. And with this die, it's again that Marion design. And here I made like small, teeny mini grungy booklet with tags. It's like extra space for journaling. And again, I used that coin envelope and I embossed it. And this is from embossing folder, from Tim Holtz embossing folder. I just cut out this piece with those numbers and I decorated with that. And when you turn it, here is again pocket. And I used those small strips of cardstock and those beads. And I made it like decoration, and it looks really gorgeous. It's just small touch, but it make that nice touch. And here again, I've got that gate tag, gate opening tag. And here again, another grungy card. Few coffee dyed pages for journaling. And here I've got another gatefold tag. And I decorated with this Utah ribbon. I hope I'm saying that right, that it's Utah ribbon. And this paper clip with this silver embellishment. And here I've got like sliding holder. This trim, it's holding this tag, and it can hold another papers or some ephemeras. And here is another memories, another page from Victoria Design. And I really like this collection. It's beautiful. It's really gorgeous. And when you turn it here, I've got CD cover again, like pocket. And I, this time, I made some kind of crazy cover of my cover. And inside, I've got this small tag. And this image of hand, when you wanna say future from your hand, from those lines. So it's here. Oops, sorry. And again, I used, like decoration, I used those strips of craft card and I just put those beads inside and I glue it over. And it's really just small touch, but really gorgeous. And on that trim, I've got very teeny, meeny, tiny embellishment and it's called, there is a touch. So I have to place it here. This, I'm just holding behind, this place like embellishment, few pages for journaling, and here we've got again this gorgeous image for storyteller, and it's on paper which is from other side like canvas, it's like fabric. So from that paper side, I print that image, from that other side I left it like canvas, and this is just some vintage paper. I'm not sure where from I've got this one. And those tags are from Victoria Design as well. And I used Tim Holtz stencil. And I stenciled it a little bit around. So it's like my tag spot. And here I made belly band. Those images I've got from Pinterest. This is from Victoria Design, and again, we've got this gatefolded tag, here is like pocket, and I've got this image here, it's just extra space for journaling, and here I've got belly band, and again, that gatefolded tag, and few coffee dyed pages, and here I've got small, teeny, meeny, small envelope. Oops. I'm not sure if I placed something inside. Oh, I guess. Just small, small tag for journaling. Extra tag for journaling. Got it here. Those cocks. Yeah, can't go there. Okay. And here I've got that other half of that envelope, like pocket. Here it's just like belly band. I made it using this tag from Victoria Design. And here I've got small opening space for journaling. It's just my leftover from 12 by 12 page. So I use it like extra space for journaling. And I use this trim and that cock for closure. Like a closure, and here is pocket, and I've got those images, again Victoria Design, and this is your looks in your hand, so you can read it, where is your look in your hand. I'm not sure if I've got any this year. It's really horrible. And from other side I've got again two pockets with those simple tags. Yeah, same, and I used again those laces like embellishment, and this image from Pinterest. And here I've got like small tag spot. This is again ticket from Victoria Design. This is my design, my tag. Very simple vintage tag. I think those papers, those vintage papers, are also from Victoria Design, but I'm not sure. Hopefully, I'm right. Again, few coffee dyed papers. And here I've got opening space, and I use this doily like my pockets. So it's pocket here, and I use this tag. I put there this tag from Victoria Design again, and this, Magic Googles. And when you turn it here, it's another pocket. From this side, I've got this gorgeous paper. Tuck. And again, this gatefolded tuck. Extra space for journaling. Again, paper for writing. This is like just embellishment. And here I've got another belly band, and I used again laces, and I made those simple tags, maybe for photographies or for some notes, for some important notes. And we are nearly on the end. Here I've got like tag spots and those images. And I'm gonna send a little bit more to Angie to make her busy while she was getting better after her surgery. I really wish her to get well as soon as possible, and I really hope she will like this journal. It was so fun, and I really like all those images I used because it's in my style. It's in that grungy style. So I really hope she will like it. I will include loads of more. I have to cut them out from sheets. Thank you so much for all your amazing comments. I'm gonna sit down and start to answer all those amazing comments I've got on my YouTube. I wasn't able before. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I really hope you will like this project. And I hope you will go check out ladies who are crafting for that craft fair now, because they've got amazing ideas. And I found myself how hard it is to make something in more quantity. Like when I tried to wrap chocolates, I made only 8 chocolates, but it took me all day. It was horrible. I was just like, oh my god, it's getting so long time, and it's so many things you have to do. So you've got my huge respect, all of you who are working every year, crafting every year for a craft fair, because it's not easy at all. It looks easy, but it's not easy at all. So, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for all your amazing ideas you're sharing every day, because it's, oh my god, it's just, I don't have a right word now. I've got in Czech language, but I don't know how to say that in English, but it's amazing, and I believe I'm saying that for behind all craft family, that it's blessed for us, that all of you sharing your amazing ideas. This is my sharing for today. I'm gonna try to take one more video, but I will share it later. Hopefully it will be my design team project for Minds Berety. I've got it here for more than a month, and I have to share it already because it's gorgeous. It's so cute. So hopefully you will like it. Hopefully Angie will like it. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for your amazing support, comments. Take care and see you next time. Bye.